Hi guys, it's Aimee, golf coach. Welcome to Basic Putting Series. To start it off, I brought several different designs of putters today, and we're going to talk about the differences they make depending on the design. That way we can really learn more about the different putters, and hopefully it'll help you to pick the right putter for you in the future. Let's get started. Subscribe, like, comment down below how your golf game is now. Back to the golf lesson. As you can see, I have several different designs here, different heads, different necks, different shafts, different grips, etc., etc. There's so many options out there. And I have to say, new technology is just surprising me every day. I'll be sharing my preferences over, you know, my experience, and also explain the reasons. That way you can make the right choice for yourself. Everybody's different, so please keep that in mind. First of all, when you grab a putter, you want to really pay attention to the feel. When you grip it, the first thing you can think about could be the grip, the thickness of it, the shape of it. Some grips are super thick like this one, some tapers down and gets narrow in your trail hands and super thick in the lead hands, or sometimes it's the same thickness all the way down. So the grip is very important, because with putting, quiet hands are really important, and thicker grips tend to help stop fidgeting your hands. So, but everyone's different. Some people do prefer the classical thinner type. These days I've been preferring the thicker grips. It does help me to really keep my hands quiet throughout the whole stroke. And also for the feel when you grip it. Now, how heavy does that putter feel? When you stroke it, how is the overall weight? How is the head weight? I don't like putters that are too light or too heavy, but the too heavy is the one I have the most issue with, because if the putter head is too heavy, now the ball is gonna come off a little bit hotter, it's gonna roll out more. So for me, it's harder for me to control distance, and also being aggressive through the impact is difficult for me to do, which results in like deceleration with the heavier putters, which I do not like. So I don't like heavy putters. Knowing what you like and not dislike really helps you to pick the right putter. And also the feel. When you put the putter down, does it feel like it sits comfortably? Does it feel great in your hands? Is really important, okay? And also when you stroke it back and forth, how nice does the club head stay for you? For me, I really look for super straight back and forth feeling, and I do prefer putter faces that stay fairly square and fairly straight on line. If you do this test that a lot of you guys already know of, if you balance a putter like this, see how the toe hangs down ever so slightly on this one? So this putter will naturally arc a little bit, whereas a lot of the mallets are face balanced and the face goes straight up at the sky like this. Let me try this one. I don't believe this is perfect face balance, close to it. So the toe still hangs, but a lot of the mallets go straight up and down this way. The face is facing the sky. This will be called a face balance. Face balance putters tend to stay straighter back and forth. I personally prefer this pretty blade looking putters, but when I was on tour, I had to use the mallet for its performance. I gave up the looks for it, right? So when it comes to feel, I pay a lot of attention to the putter head. I really like it to stay online and go into the golf ball nice and square without putting much effort into it. And that's why the face balance putters I love working with the most. And you can see the trend on the PGA Tour that the top players are moving toward mallets more, right? Because of the face balancedness that helps to keep that face nice and square and online. So if you take a look at this one looks like a blade. It's actually quite beautiful, but it actually performs like a mallet. Isn't that crazy? This is a brand new technology, so I kind of wanted to show you guys this. This one is called a face balance at impact, meaning this club head, even though when you test it this way, the toe drops quite a bit, it's face balance at impact. So it's designed a certain way so the club head stays super straight back and forth, and it almost squares up automatically at impact. This putter, instead of testing it this way, there is a whole new way of testing the technology of face balance at impact. You just need two tees. You're gonna stick one in this one end, and then you're gonna hold the putter up using the other. Boom, you see how the club face is straight up and down? This shows that this is face balance at impact. So let's try a different one. I've used this for years, actually. I've never tried it with this putter. So let's give it a go. So this was almost face balanced with the old way of testing, but this way, you see how it just flips way open? So even though this is face balance, during the stroke, you have to put a lot of effort into it to keep it online and square it up compared to that mini giant model I have here. So you guys learned something new. This is a brand new technology for me too. Face balance at impact is what this technology is called. Now, moving on to the visual. When you set the putter down, it has to look great to you, meaning the putter could be square to the target, but to me, certain heads don't look square, okay? So it has to look square to you and has to look gorgeous to you. You have to like the head to be able to putt well with it, right? So the visual is very important. And also the lines they have on top of the putter matters a lot too. If you compare these, now this type has really thick and long visual lines on top. I actually prefer that a lot more than a super thin. For example, take this one for example. This one, the line does not start from the very edge of the putter face. It starts in the back. I don't prefer this because it tends to throw my aiming off a little bit. Everyone's different, remember that please. So I do like thicker, longer lines. If you take this one, for example, it has even thicker lines in the back. I am pretty much okay, except for this one starting in the back rather than on top from the very edge of the face. So the lines, you wouldn't think they were very important, but they are. And also the neck. This is so visual, the neck. I don't have a gooseneck here. All I have is center shaft and the plumber neck. I do used to only prefer the plumber neck. The angles tend to help me to line up super square to the golf ball every single time. The gooseneck sometimes throws me off. I don't know why I can't align that thing up square. So I try to stay away from those. The center shaft, I didn't used to like it as much because when I hit the golf ball, the feel was kind of felt hot off the face. But I have to say, this mini giant has a center shaft, but it doesn't feel super hot off the face. It's probably the material of the head. It's a softer stainless steel. So even though it's a center shaft, the feel at the sweet spot does not throw me off. So that's part of the feel, again, we talked about earlier. So how it feels when you hit the golf ball at sweet spot matters a lot. And for me, I like the softer stainless steel. I don't prefer inserts that much, especially if you take a look at this one. This insert is not like a type of a metal. It's just that you can see here, I've been using this one for many years, and you can see that probably because this is not metal, there are some cracks and it's wearing down. So for me to think that if it wears down, it could change the performance of the insert. That's why I prefer no insert, or if there was an insert, a metal one. Now the last part is the length of the putter. I am 5'5". I know a lot of people think I'm a lot shorter, but I am part 5'5", and I prefer 33 inches. I do have slightly longer arms. I don't know, maybe because I've been golfing all my life, got longer for some reason. I'm just kidding. So what you want to do is you want to get into your golf posture. Your golf ball is supposed to be below your eye, so you go way bent over, a little bit less knee bend than your iron setup, and then you hang your arms down, right? From here, if I use a 34 inch, which I have right here, 34 inch from this position, now I'm gripping almost to the edge, right? Right here. and this extra could get caught in my jacket, or it just doesn't feel that balanced to grip all the way down. So I prefer a 33 inch. So let's try it again. You bend over, get into your putting setup, and then hang your arms, and then you grip this. See how my hands are like in the middle of the grip in this one? So when I say this, a lot of people might be like, what if I have a 34 inch and I just decide to grip it in the middle? See how now my arms have folded more, right? As opposed to here, almost straight arms here, but when it goes up, now there's deeper angles in my elbows and my wrists. When there are deeper angles here, when I start putting, they move around a lot more, giving me that inconsistent stroke, wobblier stroke. So I rather hang my arms down to where it's not all the way straight, but slight bend in the elbows this way. So that way you can really keep the joints nice and quiet and just rock your shoulders and not have them wobble around too much. A little bit lengthier arms at setup is really helpful to keep that putter head traveling quieter online. We talked about the different designs of the putters today. I hope that was super helpful to help you pick the right putter for you. And there are these little details of the feel you need to pay attention to, and the visual and the length of the club you really have to pay attention to. All these small details will come together to help you be a great putter. If you have any questions, please come to my website to Ask Aimee section. Leave your questions and comments there. I usually check that before anywhere else. In the next video, I'm going to show you the very basics of the putting to get you guys set up correctly. Thanks for golfing with me. See you in the next one. Mwah!